Alright guys, I'm back. I've cleaned up the inventory a little bit. And now we have 17 potassium nitrate blocks, which gives us 85 nitrate powder. We're going to take 70 of that and mix it with our coal. And that gives us 700 gunpowder, which is awesome. That will be enough for quite a lot of shotgun shells, as you might imagine. So, to that end, we are going to pull out the rest of our ingots from here. Huh. Looks like the timer didn't quite work out the way we expected it to. So let's fix that. Let's go ahead and melt down more ingots. And now that we have all this gunpowder, I think we'll take some of this buckshot and make some shotgun shells. Because we have plenty now. Excellent. Excellent. Truly great. Alright. So with this many shotgun shells, I think we don't have to be worried about running out of ammo anytime soon. But we do want to save some of the gunpowder that we have. Because... oh yeah, we actually have a little bit more. So, I guess we can use some of that. Maybe 20 of it. Here's what we'll do. We'll use 20 of that to make some gunpowder. There we go. 200 gunpowder. And we'll put one of those with one of these. And we'll make antibiotics out of that with our beaker. Of course, that'll take a little while, but that's okay. We have some time that we can use while the night is going on. There we go. That'll be 2.5 minutes. One log will do. Perfect. And let's turn the rest of these lead ingots into buckshot. And we have quite a bit of ammo now, and we can make quite a bit more. We're certainly not short of it. Bullet tips is what we might want to turn the rest of this lead into. So I'll be keeping the coal here as well. And I don't know where I got this cooking pot from. Hmm. Interesting. We'll also want to grab some of our coffee. I think it has by now, it should have grown. It really was a while since we planted it. So... I can't see at all, but I think it's ready, and the corn is probably ready too. So we'll harvest that when it gets a little bit lighter, and we will also probably... well, actually, maybe not. We don't need to gather any goldenrod. I think we still have 9, so we can put that off. What we do want to do is cook a little bit of coffee, though, to make sure we have that. And now that we have all the pieces for the wonderful, wonderful magnum... all we need is the Enforcer magazine. And once we have that, we'll be sporting a beautiful 44 Magnum. Since we have all the parts. And we have almost all the parts for the hunting rifle. And to the end of trying to get our Magnum, we will, and hopefully that hunting book to make the stock, we'll be checking out, I think, what this is a bookstore. If I remember correctly. And we'll also visit our iron over there and bring it back here eventually. And we'll probably stop by our mine over there to mine a little bit more resources. And then we'll probably be ready to take a dive or another stab at the hub city here. Because if we are able to get more potassium nitrate, hopefully we'll have enough gunpowder to make a little bit of explosives. Once I have maybe 2 stacks of it, I'll feel a little bit more secure. And there should be plenty of coal for that now. So we have 180. So that should be enough for everything we need. What do we do with these mushrooms? Anybody know any recipes for mushrooms? I'd love to hear about them. Because right now, I don't know. Oh, come on. I did it again. I'm sorry, guys. Forgot to press the button. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to our farm real quick, then come back here and finish cook. Uh-oh. I definitely heard zombie. I see one, two. I don't see any more. Okay, I definitely did not press number three, but okay. We can sport the pistol if the game feels we need to. Yeah, okay, so there's no other zombies, looks like. I think that was just a little meandering group of them, a mini horde, so to speak. So let's repair our guns before we go, since we have all these wonderful weapon repair kits that I made. And all we need is sticks for the last one. So let's go with that. That's a lot of sticks. We don't need that many. That should be enough. Excellent. And that, I believe, requires metal strips, but we won't worry about it for now. So let me go grab some of that food real quick. And then if nothing happens, I'll just fast forward. But since it is still 5 o'clock, I'm going to do this part on camera just in case I do get jumped. Okay, I don't see anyone. So it looks like we can pick up our coffee. Excellent. And probably some of these potatoes too. Of course, I can't actually see them, which would help. Where are you? There she is. Alright, that was some weird noise going on. I think that was the neighbors. So sorry about that if you guys heard it. Maybe I'll just edit it out and you haven't heard anything. Which is generally what I try to do, by the way. Which is why I watch all these videos, or try to watch them anyway, before I actually post them up. Which is why they take quite a while longer to make than it seems. A 30-minute video does not take 30 minutes to make, let me tell you. Alright. Takes hours, by the way. So now that I have picked up all the wonderful corn that I planted here, I think we will not be needing it anytime soon. We have... wow, that was perfect stack. I think we'll plant a little bit more just in case. We'll have 28 times... like, what, 5 is it per corn? Should be enough for a while. Oh, it's okay, I can plant it haphazardly, it's fine. I'm not worried. What just happened? What happened to my corn? It disappeared. Is it because I walked over it? Come on. Or did I just place it on top of grass or something? I don't know. Can't really see that well either. It is dark. We are trying to make the most use out of the game time that we can. And I do want to replant a lot of this coffee. However, there is a certain need for coffee right now because I don't have any. And with running zombies, it's almost like med kits. You really want to have some, especially when you need them. When you don't need them, they're still useful. But if you need them, you need them. There's many a time that I've been saved by a single coffee in my inventory, and even then almost died. So you want to make sure that you have at least one around you for that one situation that might crop up. Alright, so it looks like we replanted our farm nicely. We can go back stairs, and I'll see you guys in just a little bit. Alright guys, I'm back, and I'm cooking some antibiotics here. And I will also be cooking the coffee. So let's take it over here to this campfire and We don't quite need all of that in there, so let's just use our wood planks. And actually, I think we still have couches. There we go, that will work even better. And while that's gone, yes, let's click cook. Good idea. Thank you, guys. Let's make some crossbow bolts. And now we should be... Whoa, really? Whoa, okay, so I think that was a bug. Whoa, that's a lot of crossbow bolts. Well, you know what, game? If you're gonna screw me out of the auger, I'm keeping these. That's right. I'm gonna go ahead and keep the crazy duped crossbow bolts. Not like that's gonna really swing the game for me anyway. But, hey. If the game's gonna give it to me, I'm gonna take it, because I just know it's gonna take away something else. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and keep it. And say thank you. Actually, I'm gonna put this here. I'll probably not be needing any feathers anytime soon, though. Teehee. Alright, so now antibiotic is done. We now have 4 of them. And this will be on for another 3.5 game hours. That's not a lot. We're going to grab one with us because I tend to get hit occasionally. And that's when you really need one of those. And we'll also leave the couches behind. However, we'll grab the candles. We'll grab some of those ingots. Actually, probably won't need that many, because I expect we'll find a bunch of our ingots cooked over there at the other base, which is where we'll swing by, I guess, to go grab that iron and to try to find that bookstore. Let me see real quick here. What is this building? So this is the bookstore, I'm pretty sure. And I think this is the same bookstore. It has like a zigzag pattern on top, although you never know those ducts. They're similar in all of them. But it looks very, very similar, and I think I remember seeing that sign there. So I'm pretty sure it is a Born Noble. Let's see if we can snipe that guy. She's out of range. I can get her, though. I think we have some screechers. I'm hearing some screechers. Oh, here they come. So we're gonna try and sneak up on those guys. Let's go do that real quick. Let's see if we can, first of all. I don't know if we can, but we'll try. Try to do it quietly. Sneaky. Oh, he actually made it through one block. And we don't have our car to jump on top of. But we have our way down over here, so it's okay. Oh no! I might have reloaded my gun to make this more efficient. Trying to sneak by with an empty gun? Don't ever do that. There we go. These guys are resilient. They spawned. Okay. So we did not succeed because I did not succeed in reloading my gun like I should have. That's okay, because you know what? Experience. That's all I have to say. One word. Experience. We'll just take them out one by one. Okay, maybe not one by one. Maybe one by all of them. Alright, we don't have that much ammo for this gun, so let's just use our shotty, which is fine. I'm completely fine with that. We won't have a lot of time to be looting these guys. But that's all right. Double kill. Come on, guys. Bring it on. Let's see what you got. Oh, there's a lot more over there, huh? Come on. Bring it. Let's see what you got. Double kill. Headshot. Headshot. Loot, loot. No, not loot. Headshot. And headshot. Alright, now loot. I see you. I don't see you. And you're a crawler. Just for that, I'm gonna smack you in the head. Just for being a crawler. I know. It's politically incorrect. You should not pick on the cripples. I'm sorry. Alright, now, I think we can do the crossbow. Since we have been given so many wonderful bolts. So many wonderful bolts. Goodbye. You didn't quite make it. Almost. Nice try, though. So, let's just snipe them all. One by one. Free experience, right? We're not gonna say no to that. Can't say no to that. However, we can stop missing, hopefully. Oh, there's a nurse. Oh, we should probably save the nurses for last, actually, now that I think of it. Because if we do that, we can then loot them afterwards, and they usually have some nice loot that we usually need, like health kits. Honestly, I think they're some of the ones with the best loot, of course, excluding those ferals. Okay, so this guy doesn't want to die. He's being rude. So we'll waste a bullet on him. Ooh, that wasn't a waste. That's an antibiotic. Okay, yeah, I should probably heal up. You're right. Thank you for pointing it out. I know I have had trouble with that lately. Let's do it this way. Oh, hey there. Of course, that alerted the horde. Yeah, I heard him. I'm not gonna let any of these guys live. Make sure there's nobody behind us. Good, good. Not much missing going on, which is great. And now we can deal with these fat guys with a shotgun. Oh wow, three of them. There we go. That's how you do it. That's how you deal with these buggers. That's more candles out of those guys. I love making candles out of fat zombies. Whoa. Whoa, look at her hand. What's wrong with your hand, lady? And your neck. Ugh. I can't believe a shotgun did that. It's some kind of X-Files stuff right there. Oh, goodbye. Oh, that was bad. That was pretty bad. And that was a bad miss. Oh my gosh, there's three of these guys. Three crawlers. Alright, this is taking a little bit too long. So let's just deal with them with a shotgun. Nope. I see you there. Whee! Jump over the gore block. And jump over the gore block. All right. That was so much fun. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot about you guys. Don't worry. I got some for you, too. But you get the club. Goodbye. And the last one gets a critical. Just because he's special. He's the last one. Okie dokie. So we have managed to kill the Horde rather easily. Yawn and all that. I think someone got stuck in this house though. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Hello, lady. Oh, I'm so sorry. I know you should not do that, even to a lady, but it's the only part I can hit, so hey, what can I do? Besides, it's doing like no damage. You got one tough crutch, young lady. Wow, her arm kind of grabbed by that frame. That was pretty cool. That was actually pretty cool. Yeah, okay, I'm not gonna get stuck like she did. That's not a good idea. So there we go. We have made a few new friends. There they are. They'll soon be named, as all gore blocks are. There's Bob and George right there. Yes, and unfortunately, Tom 1 through 8 disappeared. They were here, but they're no longer here. They're no longer with us. They have gone to the gore block heaven. They will not be back. But it's okay, because we'll replace them soon enough. Oh, come on. Come on, game. Why you do this to me? At least you didn't break my leg. There's a bit of mercy this time around. All we're doing is wasting a first aid kit. It's those doors. I keep slamming them on my butt and like boosting myself right through the ceiling. Oh, come on. Again? I just killed the last group of them. Okay. So we're just gonna go ahead and grab our stuff now. There's been enough of that going on. It's time to go. Time to go and have an adventure. Although we should probably smelt this stuff all the way, because it's been buggy. So that's what we're gonna do. Our final hurrah at this base, for now at least. We'll go ahead and cook some of these antibiotics. And of course, I'll be doing that off camera. Yeah, we're gonna need one. There we go. That'll give us time to finish the antibiotics and the lead, which will work out pretty well. We have coffee, and I think we have everything else. So let me do some inventory management, and I'll see you guys in a sec. Alright guys, so we are basically ready to go. I just wanted to show you that I do have a auger blade and some gas. Unfortunately, we can't really use the gas right now, but eventually we will be able to. And until then, we're just going to go ahead and keep storing it. Hopefully I'll find some more auger pieces at the hardware store when I do get there. And all I need is the small engine and handlebars, and I think, I'm not sure, but for some reason I think that I have some somewhere in another chest. I'm starting to have too many chests, unfortunately. I'm really not sure about that. I think there's like a, maybe a 20% chance, but for some reason I keep thinking that I found two pairs of handlebars. Whether that's true or not, well, we'll just have to see. But let me just go ahead and put this in here. Actually, let's make that directly into our shotgun ammo. There we go. We have plenty now. Oh, this will be enough for ages. I mean, I could have so much shotgun shells right now, but there's no point in actually making them yet. I am going to grab these because we'll definitely need them. I'm going to grab these iron bars, and you'll see why real quick. And I'm going to go ahead and head down and outside. And let's see if we can Give me a second. Did I loot this? Yes, I did. Okay, good. Just making sure. I wanted to put those bars right there, because we'll still be able to shoot the crossbow, but hopefully we won't at least fall. There we go. If we're like right here, we can still shoot the crossbow at them just fine, but now the space there where we can actually fall is much smaller. So there we go. And we can shoot at them if they start crowding like crazy. And maybe we should even put some siding on here. Some reinforced metal siding. So let's see if we can... four scrap iron. Oh, I don't have any on me. I forgot it. Oh well. We'll do that later, I guess, then. We'll just head out this way. And I did drop off some stew. Right here, there we go. So we'll drink some of that stew. Oops. There we are. And now we're full. Not quite on the water, but at least our wellness is now definitely on the rise. We can eat the antibiotics whenever we need. So let's go and see if we can find these spiders. Let's see if we can figure out where they are exactly before they see us. It sounds like they're over there. So we're just going to crouch down here and peek out. Peek out. There we go. There we go. Come on. Come on. Can we see their heads? There we go. There we go. Excellent. Sneaky kills. So, two down. There should be another one somewhere, but he could have probably ran past and those guys could have gotten stuck. That's very possible. Alright, so now I'm going to take a run to the midway point where our chest is, and I'll see you guys once I'm there, or if I get in some interesting combat, of course, I will let you guys know. So, see you in a bit. Alright guys, we are here. I, of course, built this campfire last time, and of course, as campfires tend to do, it got bugged. Yay! Bugged campfires. So, this gives us 25 more potential candles. And I did kill a piggy on the way here. So now we have a nice little buildup of different food items that we will be able to grab with us when we leave. Or when we're coming back, rather, this way, because we won't be doing that for probably at least another 24 hours, I would imagine, in game time. And we'll leave everything that we don't need, really. And we'll go on to the town. So I just wanted to let you know that I have that campfire there, and I'll be periodically cooking things in there, just like I am over there. I kind of like this style of, you know, moving around from place to place and having multiple campfires, because it really it narrows down the amount of those spider zombies that you get. And while I do enjoy fighting those hordes, you know I do, it kind of gets tedious a little bit after a little while, so I prefer to, you know, not overdo it. So here's our mine that we decided was not fit for Zeo. And here is, I believe, where is it? There is a ladder somewhere here. I know that. Ah, there it is. Alright, so here's where we built our forges. As you can see, we have a nice healthy amount of ingots here, even though they're only in one spot, but that's alright. So I think we'll go ahead and refuel here. There we go, now we have quite a bit of ingots on us, and we're going to go check out that library, or bookstore rather, and hopefully this will give us enough time to come back here later on and grab the rest of this iron. Look at that. There's more iron right there, right near the surface. It might be a good idea for us to get that to have a lot of scrap iron. If we want to build out of scrap iron, which I do. So let's go to the bookstore first. And then we can see about that. Although I am going to be killing some zombies. Because this part of town, I think, has not been explored too much. And I want to use some of those crossbow bolts because I took a few extras over the stack limit. Because I knew I would be fighting some zombies before I got to my eventual destination. So I want to make sure I get rid of those. I would only have 250 left or so. And I did the same thing with shotgun shells. Okay, I just looted that car and it was empty. We are on the lookout for cars, by the way, because they have auger parts and gas and other nice things. Okay, so we have to move. It was nice standing in one spot, but I guess you can't do it all the time. Or forever, with many zombies coming at you. Nope, I saw you. Saw you out of my rear eyes, which are actually my ears, and I actually heard you. Alright. So let's see if we can loot a couple more of these guys. Hey there. And level 24. Awesome. We're moving on up in the world. Now, this prize car has oil. That's alright. It's not too bad. Could be better, could be worse. But I do hear some... I really don't care about that. I just remembered how much crossbow bolts I have, or how many. So let's get these guys to follow us. Let's grab this car. And kill some of these fellows. Let's get some of them, more of them, to follow us. Oh wow, okay, we have a lot of them. So now I think we can start killing them. Now that we got a nice group, horde-like group.